Hi, and welcome to this Tech Insights video. My name is Mary, and I'm an application engineer here at IFM Effector. You are here because you have either purchased or plan to purchase one of our LMT sanitary point level sensors. In this video, we are going to go over the programming of these sensors. So let's get started. So here you have the Learn More section on our website for our LMT series level sensors. In this video, we are going over the programming of these sensors, and that section can be found under the Setup and Support tab on the left-hand side. It is important to note that these sensors can only be configured through our IO-Link software, and this section shows you the parameters that are able to be changed through that software. So now let me take you into our moneo configure software and show you how to parameterize these sensors. So here we have the moneo configure software, which is our IO-Link configuration software. In order to connect to the sensor that you want to parameterize, you'll go to where it says network scan. For this example, I'm using an LMT-121 connected to our E30390 programming cable. So I will select USB port, IO-Link master, E30390, and click scan. Here you can see the software is beginning to connect to the sensor, and once it has found it, you will see the LMT-121 appear. I will then click on this sensor, and it'll begin to pull in the identification information and parameters that I can change for this sensor. So here you can see the vendor ID and device ID of the LMT-121, the name of the sensor that is pulled in, as well as the description of the sensor. If you scroll further down, you will see the different parameters that you can change, such as the output configuration, the set points for output 1 and output 2, as well as any fault and delay configurations that you want to change. We also, to the right, have this gauge icon, and if you click on this, it'll take you into the cockpit view, which is where you can see real-time data that the sensor is reading. So now let me show you the sensor I am using and the setup I have and show you the real-time data that it is reading. So here we have the LMT-121 that I am using in this video. We have different options available with different probe lengths and factory settings defaulted onto the sensor. I also have an LMT-121 that is mounted into a pipe with dish soap. I'm now going to take you back into the moneo configure software so that you can see the real-time values that the sensor reads when it is submerged in the soap versus when it is out of the soap. So now let me take you back into the software. The first thing I wanted to show you how to do is how to factory reset the sensor so that it is at the settings that it is out of the box. So if you scroll to the bottom of the moneo configure software, you will see a restore factory settings tab that you can press. So I'm going to press that now, and you will see that when it has been successfully written to the sensor, a done window will pop up in the bottom. So now if I scroll back to the top, you can see that digital output 1, the set point is set for 35%, and the reset point is set for 29%. Output 2 also has the same settings, but output 1 is normally open and output 2 is normally closed. So now let me take you back into the cockpit view. You can currently see that the sensor is submerged in the dish soap and it is reading about 85% or 87%, which you can see up here. If I then lift it so that the tip of the sensor comes out of the dish soap, you can see that the value has now dropped to 0. And similarly, if I slowly lower the sensor so that it slowly is submerged into the dish soap, you will see the values begin to increase depending on how much of the sensor is submerged. You can also change your set point and reset point settings for the outputs on the LMT sensor. So like I said before, it is currently set for 35% and 29%. So you can see output 1 is on when the values are reading over 35%. And when they are under the 29%, the output is off, and vice versa for output 2. So now if I slowly lower it until 35 is reached, you see output 1 go on and output 2 go off. So now if I want to change those settings For example, I can set it for 85 and 60%. Once you write those settings into the software, you will then go to the bottom right-hand corner where it says write to device. And if I click on that, it'll write those parameters to the device and let me know when that has been done successfully. So now if I take the sensor back out of the media and it is reading zero, output one is off again. And if I slowly lower it, even though 35% has been reached, output one is still not on until it reaches 85%. So that concludes this Tech Insights video on the programming of our LMT sanitary point level sensors. As always, you can check out our Learn More section on our website for helpful information on any of our products. Feel free to contact us at info.us@ifm.com or call into 1-800-441-8246 to speak with somebody who can assist you. Thank you for your time and have a great day.